We had one out of New Zealand very swiftly after one out of the United States.
Yes, so there are two launches. The launch in the United States is for a customer that the Rocket Lab has not yet disclosed. In the past, Rocket Lab has done launches from Virginia for US government customers. The launch in New Zealand was for a French startup. This was part of a multiple launch contract that Rocket Lab has with them. So altogether, this makes 14 launches that Rocket Lab has had this year, which beats their record, which was 10 last year. Let's put this in context. Impressive for Rocket Lab, but yeah. Remember that SpaceX has had more than 100 launches this year.
They are very much still an also-ran at the moment, but they're clearly garnering some momentum here. What's interesting is they're also getting money from the US government when it comes to chips. Where else in the manufacturing area are they, and why are they getting such money from the Commerce Department?
So this is the final signing of a contract from the Department of Commerce related to the CHIPS Act, $23.9 million. The company had announced a preliminary deal for this before, so this is not a surprise. Mm. People knew this was coming. Rocket Lab has a subsidiary in New Mexico that makes solar cells. It's one of the only companies, I believe there are only two in the United States, that make these components. So Rocket Lab has now gotten funding from Commerce Department to promote that, to build more of those. So just giving another lift to this stock. Interesting what you were talking about with Craig earlier about optimism about post-election. Rocket Lab is one company among several space companies also benefiting from this bullishness after Trump's re-election, that the new administration will have policies that will be favorable to the sector.